Hi, and thanks very much for joining me. I'm Dean the Vaping Biker, and today we're going to be doing something that's a little bit niche, maybe a little bit not for everybody, but hopefully it does help a few people. Now, I get a lot of questions, a lot of emails and private messages asking how I take my photographs and expecting them to be taken on flash cameras and all that sort of stuff. Now, that's really not the case, and everything I do is on the Samsung S6 mobile phone. Everything that we're going to go through today, none of it is proper photography. None of it is proper photography. I don't understand proper photography as yet. And whilst I do try and learn from time to time, it's really difficult to wrap my head around. So I like things to be easy. I like them to be simple and straightforward. And that's why I've done this kind of instructional. It's not really a tutorial. It's kind of showing you how I go about getting things like coil shots, atomizer shots, and all that sort of good shit. So, the idea really is to be able to show you how I do it, and then hopefully it might give you a couple of options that will make you sort of be aware of a couple of options that you weren't before, so you can take some really whizzy pictures of your atomizers or coils or what have you. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the equipment that I'm going to be using today and what you can use and, you know, if you want to. So I'll tell you all about that. Then we'll go into the up close. Then we'll take some pictures. I'll show you the software on how I edit them. And then we'll come back up for some sort of rounding up. How does that sound? Right, let's go to the next section. Okay, time for a vape. Rocking the Velocity on top of the SXQ Mini Q with some Vaptasia Royalty 2 in it at the moment, which is fantastic. Anyway, so this is the section that's going to tell you all of the bits and pieces that I am going to use. Now, the first and foremost, the most important piece is the phone itself. You do need to have a phone to do what I'm about to do. Now, I'm using, obviously, the Samsung Android S6, which is, I think it's a couple of years old now, so it's not super flash and super whizzy. A bunch of the older Samsungs do a similar sort of operational things. And, you know, you do have similar options with a whole bunch of the Android phones. I believe iPhone also has access to the software I'm going to show you. And I think the newer iPhones have even better cameras and, you know, all sorts of things. But hopefully this is a way I'm going to show you about getting the best out of the camera that you are using on your phone. So we've got the phone itself. Now then, to help support, actually no, before I tell you about that, the other thing that I've used for a long, long time is just a little LED goosenecked clip-on light. You can use this via USB power or battery power, and I found this to be really useful because I was able to pop this on the desk and then I could move this light around to really focus it on whatever I was taking a picture of, or the background if I wanted the foreground to stand, excuse me, the foreground to stand out. But I was using that. However, a company called Aukey, A-U-K-E-Y, has sent me a few bits and bobs that I've got to review. But at the same time, I chose these particular bits because they're affordable ways to help making your coil and RDA photography a little bit better. And it's also hopefully going to save a little bit of money in the short term. Now, one of the things, and the most expensive piece, don't be put off by this. I showed you the cheap and cheerful light. This is a light that Aukey does do as well. I know it's you're not really getting a great show of it there. But this is all kind of, you can move it up and down. You can tilt it wherever you fancy. And one of the great things about this is the LED panel here is kind of acts as a diffuser as well, so it isn't quite as harsh a light as some lights can give you. On top of that, it's all kind of touch screen and stuff on the bottom here, which is very cool, and you can alter the light from a kind of a warm light to a real white light, and obviously make it brighter and darker as well. It's also got a USB little port on the side, so if you want to charge your mods while you're fanning around, you can. Now, that is something that was sent to me free, and I want to be up and honest about that one, because while it's lovely and it is great to have, it's certainly not essential in the grand scheme of things. Now then, the other couple of things that I've been sent is we do have a tripod here, which is an Aukey tripod, which I think is just super useful. Now, once again, you don't have to have a tripod. You can pick them up cheap as chips. However, this one is, I think it's just crazy low money. It's like £9 on Amazon Prime for this at the moment in the UK, which is cheap as you like. You've got a like a ball thing on the top there, so you can move that around and lock it in a place exactly where you want it. And it just is super, super useful. If you don't have a tripod, then you can obviously lean your phone on things and stuff, which is certainly things that, or something that I've done a lot of in the past, but it's not ideal. If you can get a little sort of tripod for your desk, it does make things a lot easier if you're going to do it in the long term. Now then, the other thing to tell you about is, while once again, these aren't essential, these are other ways of helping really improve the shots that you've got. Now, I've got two types of fisheye / macro lens from Aukey as well. I wanted to find out which one was going to be better for the application that we're using it for, and I've certainly got a favorite out of those two, which I'll talk about at the end as well. Now, all in all, I'm pretty sure that is about it. The phone, the lens, the light. Oh yeah, what else I've got is just some bits of black card off Amazon, just to hold as backgrounds. Now, if you've been looking at a lot of my kind of thumbnails and all that sort of stuff, you'll notice that I also do things like, and I actually do my reviews on these, a chopping board. It's a really nice piece of wood, but it's a chopping board which makes a really great backdrop for up close sections of reviews, but it also makes a really sexy backdrop for pictures as well. So yeah, hopefully we'll be able to come out with some decent shots from this one today. Right, so that's all the gear. Let's set things up and start going through how we're doing stuff, shall we? Go on then. Okay, so here we are with the desk itself. It's looking messy. There's shit everywhere. I know that one. But we're going to make this into our little studio now. Now, what I've got is I've got my light up here, which I showed you a moment ago. Whoop, making it fall over all over the place. But that's the head of the light there, and you can see the base underneath here over here. We'll be using this light in a little while, and I'll show you how I'm going to use that in a bit. But up first, what I want to do is I want to kind of create a little bit more of a delicate kind of photo area, if you like. So I'm going to get just a big old block of card that I may have showed you. If not, I will show you again, just to use this as a backdrop, because it's nice and dark and just makes things look cool. This can be any color you like, but I'm choosing black just for effect. Now I'm going to show you how I set up the shot, and then we'll have a little look from there. Now then, first off, this is the Aukey tripod that I've shown you in the up top section, and I think this is a pretty decent little tripod. It's nice and solid when it's sitting upright. Plus, you do have one of these little catches here, so you can undo this and then swivel this around and lock it into place. And it's on a little ball going on under here. So yeah, I find that super useful, to be honest with you. But what we're going to do is we're going to get the phone in here, just to make sure it's held in there nice and securely. And then once we've done that, we can then kind of start thinking about setting up our shot. So what I want to do at this point is I am going to pop on the macro lens, which I will talk to you about, but I'll show you in a little while the difference the macro lens does make. But it just means that it's there for the moment, and it helps me set stuff up. So what I will need to do now is I've got a couple of bits of foam here, which I'm going to use as a kind of a plinth, if you like. They're just little bits of packing foam, so nothing to get overly excited about. I'm going to use one of the Aukey boxes to put that on top of, and I'm then going to get one of my coils and just stick that on top of the packing box, or on top of the little plinth that I've created. So you can see here, nothing really to get too excited about. We've got the black backdrop happening, and like I say, I will show you the setup in a little while. But pretty much that's it with regards to getting things together. The rest of it will tend to be shown when I do the focus on what's going on with the phone itself, which I'll go to in a second. The other thing is, though, I've just got one light directly above me at the moment. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this light on, and it just gives a little bit extra brightness to the focus point of what we're doing. Now, at the same time, you can see at the back we've got some of that light going on there. If we turn off the top light, then that gives us a far more dramatic backdrop. So yeah, this is just using the desk light, and for that we'll go into how we set it up exactly. All right, so this is pretty much where we were a second ago. I've just moved the phone out of the way and I've turned this light off again, just so you can really see the difference and the benefit that it makes. So by popping that light on again, then we are nice and alight, and as you can see, we've got that that big light just overhanging there to give us this kind of situation going on here. Now I'm trying to get the camera stable so we're not too iffy when we go to the next stage. Now, if I turn off the main room light, then you can see once again that we are really kind of focused on with the focused in on that coil being nice and bright. But we'll come to that in a second. Right, so let's go onto the camera app on the phone so we can see exactly what we're doing. Now, I'm sorry about the refresh rate. There's not really a great deal I can do about that, I'm afraid. Now, then, if I take this off for the second, let's have a little look-see. I do want this to be a little bit higher, actually. So we'll just move the plinth around a little bit. By having it a little bit higher, it means that I can move the camera in closer and get a real kind of tight shot of this coil and having it look the way I want it to look. Right, now at the moment, see if we can get in on this phone situation here. At the moment, we are very, very bright on the coil and we're not very focused on it either. So what I want to do is I want to try and get focus on there. Now, like with a lot of phones, if you click on it, it will try and focus itself, but it's still not massively, massively in touch with itself. Now, if I take that picture, maybe you'll be able to see if I do this, that we have got a fair amount of accuracy on the picture itself, but it's very blurry, particularly on this top end here, and it's not as crisp as we'd like it. So let's have a little look and see what we can do about that. Now, at this point, this is where I'd say that if you don't have a macro lens, you can still get some pretty decent pictures. I've moved the camera back ever so slightly, and that really, really does make all the difference, because that really has given us a lot of crispness when we zoom in. However, because we're zooming in, the darker sections tend to be a little bit on the noisier side, so not quite as dark and swish as we'd like, to be honest with you. This is where the macro lens comes in. So if we pop that on here, like so, we can now move the phone really close to that coil, and we're still able to get a little bit more detail coming out. So we can, the better picture you can get before you have to worry about zooming in, the better you're going to be in the long term. So now we've got a really kind of pretty sharp picture. We've lost a lot of the kind of blurriness on the top of the coil, and that gives us a definite amount of sharpness to play with there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep just gently moving it in, just to really get as close as I can. Now then, once we're in this situation, we've been using the autofocus, which does an average job, but what I want to do is I'm going to click on the mode button. A lot of these phones have mode buttons now, so if we click on that, this takes us to the Pro. Now, if we click on Pro, don't get too worried about all of the comings and goings of what's going on there, because we can sort this out no problem whatsoever. What we've got on this manual situation at the top here is this allows us to, this is a slider that gives us the opportunity to manually focus. So I can bring that in or out depending on where I've set the coil. You might be able to see that going in and out of focus. So what I want to do is I'm going to go there, make sure we're as focused as we can be. And also focus on the right part of the coil as well, because what you may be able to see there is that we have, because of the depth of field, we have a fair bit of blurriness going on in the background, which can look pretty damn sweet. Now what I'm going to do as well is turn the top light off, the room light. So we'll take that off like so. Now I know it's a lot brighter on the camera. Let me see if I can just take that down a little bit to give you a fairer representation of what I'm seeing. And it's a little bit more like that, which in itself already isn't too bad. Then what we've got, the two things that I'll then play with is the ISO and the shutter speed. Now, there are clever things that clever photographer people will tell you about all this sort of stuff. However, personally for me, I kind of have a little bit of a fiddle with it and get it pretty much where I want. You don't want to be going too high on these shutter speeds, and at the same time you don't want to be going too low. The higher you are, the less light it leaves in, and the slower you are, the bigger the photo, I think, essentially. But I'm no photographer, so you know. But let's have a little look at this shutter speed here. You see what I'm doing here, shutter speed, as I take it down, it goes a lot darker because it's so quick, it's not letting very much light in at all. What I'm doing is I'm just getting it to where I want it to be to get me a real kind of feel for that macro shot. Little double click on, double check on the old focus to get it exactly where I want it. And there we go. Now you'll see inside the macro lens holder that I've got the snapper set on 2 seconds. That means that if you're touching it, you've got ever so much chance of being able to knock it over slightly, or if you're touching the table or anything like that, and that can throw yourself all out of focus. So what I'm going to do now is we're set on 2 seconds, so I'm going to click the fire button and then let it count down and it'll take the shot. Now this is where we get to the fun things. So what we've got now is we've got the picture of the coil, like so. And if I take this down, can you see it? Kind of. If I remember, I'll stick a little picture up in the corner to show you where we're at this current stage. And now what I'm going to do is I am going to show you how to use the app. Right, so I've angled the phone, so hopefully we don't get too much refraction and seeing shadows of me in the background. So let's have a little look at exactly what we're going to be using to help refine this shot a little bit. We're going to use an app called Snapseed. And I really do think that this is a cracking app for a whole bunch of reasons. However, if we go into the top corner there to open, this is the most recent picture that we've just taken a shot of. And you can see that that is the coil sitting there, proud as punch, on top of the little plinth that we made. Now one of the first things that I want to do is I want to crop it. So to use the app, it's just nice and easy. You've got this little, you've got a little pin symbol down in the bottom corner here. You click on that, and that gives us, whoops, that gives us the option to crop the image. So that's what we want to do to start with, get that little cropped in there so we've got real focus on exactly what we want to be paying attention to. Just like that. And it depends, obviously, what kind of floats your boat, what kind of image floats your boat with regards to how much of that we get and how much of that we don't. So I've just accepted that, and there we go, a nice kind of funky little shot, but still I think we can make it a little bit better. So we're going back into the options, we're going to tune the image. Now this, to tune an image, we now get a whole bunch of options here where we've got brightness, contrast, saturation, ambience, highlights, shadows, all that sort of good stuff. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just have a little bit of a play. I'm going to bring the ambience up just a touch. I'm going to take the highlights down just a touch. The shadows, we're going to take those down a little bit as well. Just so we've got a real kind of nice moody section going on around here now. It's nice and dark. It really is kind of making this coil really, really stand out now. So from that point on, I'm pretty happy with that, to be honest with you. You can have a little bit of a play, maybe increase the contrast just a touch. And obviously you've got the brightness that you can fanny about with as well. But really it's one of those things that you can just have a little play with to really go with how you feel it should work, you know. Once you've done that, you've got a little tick down at the bottom here. You may or may not be able to see in frame, so I've just clicked that tick to accept the changes that I've made. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use something called tonal contrast. So once you've got all these options up here that you can muck about with, you do also have this tonal contrast one down the bottom here. Now doing that, it does what it says on the tin, and it just really crisps everything up nicely, because you know there really is a nice proper contrast between the lights and the darks and the colors. So with that in mind, I'm not going to mess around with it. You do have a whole bunch of options that you can muck about with if you so want to, but generally I find that it kind of hits it pretty much where I want it to be straight off the bat. So we'll accept that one. Now in itself, once again, I think that looks pretty damn sweet, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do one more thing, and that's just using the vignette tool. So we're going to do that. We're going to choose, I'm going to highlight just the coil just there, and what we're going to do is this is going to just darken up a few of those corners a little bit, and it just makes it kind of a little bit artier, in my opinion, for what it's worth. And so now we've got this this coil kind of sitting amongst the darkness, which I think looks the business. A quick tick and away we go again. And that is how I do my up close and personals for the coils. And you can see the clarity, if we zoom in, you can see the clarity of what we've done today, which I think for a camera phone is pretty damn good, to be honest with you. Anyway, with that in mind, let's go save it, and then we can go up top and I'll talk to you a little bit more. Right, something else I did want to talk about was just the importance of having a decent little backdrop, or how backdrops can really change what you're doing. So at the moment, what I've set up there is just, this is the cough from Hoppen Vape, their new little tank. So what I wanted to do was show you the difference and the impact that a different funky little background can make. So what we've got now is we've got this set up pretty much as we set up the previous one, which has got the light above us. We've also got the little Aukey light showing directly on top of the coil itself, so I can take that off and we're super dark. We'll bring that back up again and everyone's a winner. Now once again, we are in manual mode, so I've been able to fanny around with everything to get what I think is a reasonable little shot there. Now then, what I'll do is if I take a photograph, that's taking too much time. Look, go back in the pro. There we go, and that's remembered the settings. So what I'll do is, let me just make sure that that is as tight as I can get it on that. Okay, I think that's pretty much there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a picture of that there, and I'm going to share that up in the corner at this moment in time, just so you can see what that looks like and get a general sort of feel for that. Now then, if we take, instead of having the black background, if we now put a piece of white paper behind it, now we've got an entirely different feel for the shot. It now looks kind of way more kind of marketing and funky and all that sort of stuff. So we definitely do have a completely different vibe. And you can see that I've got the lens over that ever so slightly, there we go. But now we've got a completely different feel for it. So without changing anything, we'll take a picture of that as well, and I'll once again put that in the top corner. Now finally, if we want to, we can try a different style of background altogether, and I'll talk about this a little bit more later. But there we go, once again, everything's the same, but we'll take a picture like that. So what I'll do is, I've not changed the light or anything like that, but what I'll do is I'll put all three pictures up so you can compare the three of them, because it's just really, really important to understand the difference the background will make, and that's before you start editing it and mucking about with it and all that sort of good stuff. Right, now based on that, let's go back up top. Right, so that was going through how I set up the shots for my up close and personals. Let's have a little vape. This Royalty 2 juice from Vaptasia is fucking gorgeous. It really is. Anyway, right, let's get into stuff. Now then, Hopefully what you've seen so far will be useful, but some people will be wondering about the stuff that I've been using. So as I showed you, I am using, or I have been using, the light from Aukey, and as I said earlier on, that having this diffuser thing going on here I think is absolutely splendid. Now then, I wonder if I can show you, I don't know if it's going to come through on camera very well or not, but let's have a little look at this one. Now, if I turn my main lights off, now then, if we go see if this can, you can see that goes a little bit yellower and a little bit warmer, or we can go whiter and go for a bit of a kind of a harsher light. And at the same time, I can take this down, or I can increase the brightness on it as well. So this light, I do think, is brilliant for a desk light. Or for helping taking photographs. I think it's really good. It's pretty well made, and having things like the USB on it and stuff always makes it useful. If you're a vapor and you want a light on your side, and you may not have your computer or a spare USB hole available to you to charge things up with, so that I think is quite good. Right. Next, we've got the tripod. As I said earlier on, I think a tripod is definitely, for the money they cost. Oh, the light, by the way, that's 45 quid. So that isn't cheap, but it's bloody good. Pardon me. Now then we've got the tripod. Tripod coming in at $8.99, so cheap as chips off Amazon Prime. I'll leave links down below, but they're not affiliate links. I must stress that they're not affiliate links in any way, shape, or form. I'll leave the full link to the Amazon products on the underneath in the description. Right then, the next thing that we've got to think about are these two macro lenses. Now then, the first one, which is a 3-in-1 wide-angle macro fisheye, wide-angle. A macro and a fisheye lens. Now this comes to you, and this stuff is always really nicely packaged. You get a little lens wipe and a bunch of paperwork to tell you about things, and you get two of these kind of clip-on affairs. Now one of them is for the fisheye stuff, and the other one is for the macro and wide angle. Now how these work is you just clip these over your phone, but you do need to make sure that obviously the bit that's going over the camera lens fully encapsulates the lens. Now this 3-in-1, whilst you'd think would be pretty good value for money, it's not bad, but I don't think it really does a great job, because I don't know if we're going to be able to sort of see this, but the hole that you've got here where that goes over your camera lens is really, really small, and it can also mean that you can kind of get a little bit of vignetting around the outside of the picture, so the corners are a little bit darker and all of that sort of good stuff. Now this one says also it's a 0.67 wide 10 times macro. Now I don't find this one to be that helpful when it comes to your macro shots. So yeah, for me personally, I found that one, let me have a little look at the price. That one was $9.99, I believe. And yeah, I didn't really kind of get to grips with it as such. I didn't really kind of enjoy using it very much at all. However, the big bad boy that we are using here, which is this one here, I will show you what else comes in the package. It's a much bigger box and all this sort of stuff. I know it's not kind of, it's not kind of vape review material to do this sort of stuff, but hopefully someone finds it useful. Now look at this. This is like a proper size lens you get. So this is for the kind of the wide angle stuff. So if you want to make your phone look like an absolute big bastard, then you certainly can. That screws on there and you can get some really, really good shots. However, what we're worried about today is the macro feature on it. And with this one, the hole that goes, gonna be able to see that hole that's just in there that gives you access to that lens is much, much bigger, so you can really make sure that when you pop it over the top of your phone, you can really make sure, can I get this in the light now, that you kind of don't have anything covering the lens on your phone. So that's pretty much it-ish, I think. I can't really see. But, there we go, we're well out. There we go. Are you going to be able to see that? You can see the sort of the chrome squarish surround around the lens on the phone, which kind of gives you a nice kind of wide angle there. Plus, I think, as we saw in the up close, it certainly does help when it comes to the sort of magnification without having to zoom in. So I think that's really, really good. Right, I think that's all the product stuff out of the way. I have got a couple of other things to try. However, the polarized lens that I've got, there's no point in me trying that inside because I need sunlight for that. And I think, is that it? That might be it actually. Anyway, right, now then, let's go on to the other things. I talked to you about backgrounds and all that sort of malarkey. Now, one of the things that you can also have a play about with is where the light is focused. So if your light is focused behind the product, the coil or the RDA or whatever else, then it can really help that, especially if you're using a dark background, it can really help make that really pop on the front there. Now, hopefully I'll be able to remember to put my picture of the velocity up in here. Now, I only had a very light amount of light on the background there, but enough to be able to separate the RDA from the background, because I wanted to sort of draw the focus and the attention of the eye into the glowing coil, which was just something that I pressed glow and I clicked on the 2 seconds on my camera, took my finger off the thing and off the mod, and then it took the picture and it was just at the right time. That can take one or two attempts to get it in the right level of glowing, but you know, you get there in the end. So you can focus the light on the background, or you can focus the light directly on the product if you want to kind of move away from having a strong background. And the best thing to do is really just have a little bit of fun playing about with it, because I think you can make some really, really effective quality pictures with very little photography knowledge, if any, and very little sort of experience or equipment, because really all I'm using that I think is absolutely worth spending the money on is the tripod and the fisheye. Now the 2-in-1s, this one is $19.99, so it is a little bit more expensive, but I think it's absolutely worth it, to be honest with you. So $19.99 for the camera lens. The stand was $8.99, so for less than £30, and this is all on Amazon's website as well. So for less than £30, if you take a lot of photos of your stuff, you can really, really make it stand out. And if you're a coil builder or something like that, that, you know, spends a lot of time on your coils, for very little money, this can help you get a better shot than just zooming in on the photos taken on the phone. And it can really get that clarity in there, because phone lenses generally have a really kind of short depth of field when you're going up close. So, you know, you can have a coil where one end of it is in focus and the other end is really not. And things like that kind of make it look a little bit woolly and a little bit manky. So, yeah, I mean, it's having things like the macro lens certainly helps. And this one absolutely gets the full thumbs up from me. Things like the lighting, absolutely important to have lighting. However, you don't need a whizzy light like this Aukey one, but I think it's fantastic. You can use cheap and cheerful versions, you know, just whatever you can find, really. If the light is too bright, I'd use things like greaseproof paper or something along those lines, just to help diffuse it. So just put a little bit of greaseproof paper over the front of the LEDs. LEDs tend to be a little bit crisper and a whiter light than a regular light bulb as well. Now then, is there anything else I can think of for telling you? Backgrounds, just be funky with it. You know, I've used everything from bubble wrap to bits of material to the chopping board. Bits of card, white backgrounds, just with a piece of A4 paper, just to make that focus thing pop. Really, the best thing is just to have a good old play with it. But hopefully, this video has been a little bit useful in one way, shape, or form. Anyway, it's been a long one. Thanks very much for watching. I've been Dean the Vaping Biker. This has been the Samsung S6 with a whole bunch of stuff to make this diddy little coil look a lot sexier on camera. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Have it large!